Hello children, welcome back. Today we are going to study subject English grammar, chapter number 3, the passive voice, part 1. The chapter is not new for us, okay? We have studied it in last year. Also, you have been studying it since you were in class 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th and so on, okay? So, heading is given as the passive voice. Not only the passive, we are going to see the active voice also. So, in this video, we are going to see the meaning of active and passive voice as well as when to use them. Hum passive voice kyun use karte hain? Hum active voice kab use karte hain? This is the basic thing. Okay? Jo janna kafi zaruri hai. It is also important. So, let us start. So, meaning is when the subject of a sentence is the doer of the action, it is called as active voice. Active voice कब कहलाएगा? जब sentence के अंदर जो subject होता है, when it is a doer of an action, means it is performing the action, then only it is called as active voice. For example, you can see here, he reads a book. If you see here, this is your subject, this is your verb and this is your object. He reads a book. यहाँ पर book कौन read कर रहा है? He. Okay, he is reading a book. So ये action कर रहा है. Okay. So the thing which is at the point of subject, जो subject की जगह लिखा है और वो action कर रहा है. So according to the meaning, the subject of a sentence is the doer of the action. जब वो action को perform करता है, then it is called as active voice. So this sentence is in which voice? It is in active voice because at the place of subject jo likha gaya hai, it is performing the action. Okay, next thing, format of writing as active voice. Active voice written in this format, sentence aise likha jata hai. First comes the subject, then the verb, and lastly comes the object. In this way we write a sentence. Aise sentence formation hota hai. Kiska? Active voice mein assertive sentence. Okay, now let us move forward. When to use active voice? हमें active voice कब use करना है या हम कब use कर सकते हैं? ठीक है? So basically देखा जाए तो whatever we speak there are two ways. Okay, one way is speaking in active voice, the other way is speaking in passive voice. अब active voice कब use करना है? The actor, performer, doer of an action is known. Means action करने वाला जब हमें पता होता है, तब जाके we use the active voice. जैसे कि यहाँ पे लिखा है, he reads a book. मतलब वो किताब पढ़ रहा है, right? अगर मुझे पता ही नहीं है कि read करने वाला वो है, ठीक है, वो वहाँ पर है. So मैं subject की जगह क्या लिखूँगा? I don't know. So it is necessary कि the actor performer of the action should be known. Next point. The actor performer or the doer. ठीक है, तीन चीजें मैंने लिखी. Actor मतलब action करने वाला. He is the same performer or the doer of an action. अलग अलग meaning में अलग अलग word use किए जाते हैं. So it should be relevant. Relevant means what? It means important. जब action करने वाला हमारे लिए important होता है, then we use the active voice. Okay. और अगर action करने वाला important नहीं होता है, तो हम passive voice use करेंगे. ठीक है? This was the second point or the second reason why to use active voice. Okay, for example, मुझे बताना है कि ये विंडो उस लड़के ने तोड़ा है. So I am going to say, Rahul broke the window. ठीक है, तो मुझे बताना है कि एक्शन करने वाला राहुल है. So when it is important, relevant, उसका नाम लेना, सब्जेक्ट के बारे में डिस्क्लोज करना, then we use the active voice. Okay, now passive voice. When the subject of a sentence is the receiver of the action, it is called passive voice. पैसिव वॉइस क्या होता है? व्हेन यू आर सब्जेक्ट ऑफ अ सेंटेंस, मतलब दिए गए सेंटेंस में जब आपका सब्जेक्ट के तौर पर जो वर्ड एक्ट कर रहा है वो क्या कर रहा है? इट इज रिसीवर ऑफ द एक्शन, इट इज रिसीविंग द एक्शन, तब जाके उसे हम कहते हैं पैसिव वॉइस. फॉर एग्जांपल, ओवर हियर अ बुक इज रीड बाय हिम. अ बुक इज रीड बाय हिम, ये आपका सब्जेक्ट सब्जेक्ट के तौर पे काम कर रहा है. इट इज एक्टिंग एज अ सब्जेक्ट. प्रैक्टिकली देखा जाए तो बुक जो है हमने ऑब्जेक्ट की प्लेस पे रखा था और रियली इट इज ओनली अ ऑब्जेक्ट. लेकिन it is placed at the very starting and it is acting as a subject over here. And then your object and the, sorry, this is your verb and this is acting as an object over here. Okay, at the place of object. So the thing which is at the place of subject, तो subject की place पे आगे रखा गया है and it is receiving the action. अब यहाँ पर ये क्या कर रहा है? A book is read by him. A book जो है वो किसके द्वारा पढ़ी जा रही है? By him. So again इसका meaning same होता है पहले की तरह. Action करने वाला कौन है? He is doing the action. Okay? और उसको कौन receive कर रहा है? A book. So when the thing which is written at the place of subject and when it is receiving the action which was done by the this part of the sentence, that is called as, yeah, wo sentence ko hum kahenge as passive voice. Understood? Now format of writing a passive voice is object, verb and subject. Theek hai, object aage aata hai, फिर वर्ब आता है, फिर सब्जेक्ट आता है. दोनों में कंफ्यूज मत हो जाना यहाँ पर. ओके, ये एग्जांपल जो है यहाँ पर सब्जेक्ट क्यों लिखा है? बिकॉज़ इट इज प्लेस, इट इज रिटन इन द प्लेस ऑफ सब्जेक्ट, एक्टिंग एज अ सब्जेक्ट. ओके, नाउ व्हेन टू यूज पैसिव वॉइस. ओके, एक्टिव वॉइस का हमने देखा. नाउ व्हेन टू यूज पैसिव वॉइस, देखेंगे तो क्लैरिफाइड हो जाएगा कि हमें एक्टिव में बात करनी है या पैसिव. The actor, performer, doer of an action is unknown. Okay? जब हमें पता ही नहीं होता है action किसने किया है, जब मुझे पता ही नहीं window किसने तोड़ा है, ठीक है? So मैं किसका नाम ले सकता हूँ? I cannot take anyone's name. So in that situation we use the passive voice when the actor is unknown. Second reason, the actor, performer, doer of an action is irrelevant. Action करने वाला important ही नहीं है, ठीक है? For example, कंस्ट्रक्शन का काम चल रहा है, एट एनी प्लेस बिल्डिंग बनाने में बहुत सारे मजदूर लगे थे, ठीक है? सो मैं बता रहा हूँ किसी और को, आई एम टेलिंग कि हाँ ये बिल्डिंग बनाई गई थी. सो मजदूर किसने बनाई थी, इट इज नॉट इम्पोर्टेंट. तो इम्पोर्टेंट क्या है? वो बिल्डिंग बनी है. सो एट दैट टाइम वी यूज द पैसिव वॉइस व्हेन यू आर एक्शन करने वाला जो है इट इज इररिलेवेंट. तो हम कहते हैं बिल्डिंग बनाई गई थी. एंड व्हेन we do not want to disclose the doer. Okay, जब हम we do not want to disclose, जब action करने वाला important नहीं होता है, it is irrelevant. And at that time, if we do not want to disclose him, then we use the passive voice. Okay, again, when it is unknown, पता ही नहीं है, when it is irrelevant and we do not want to disclose them, then we use the passive voice. Okay, I hope you understood the meaning and use of it. Next thing is about the use of pronouns. Okay, this side we use in active voice and this side ye wale we use in passive voice. Means at the place of subject, these are for subject and these are for the object. You can see all these word at the place of object. Matlab jo aakhir mein aate hai, this one you can see him over here at the place of object we have written. Okay, and the place of subject basically at every time we write up this word. Okay, ye pronoun. So how pronouns are changed? I is changed into me, we into us, you remains the same, he into him, she into her, it remains the same, they into them. So students, this is also very much important when you change sentence from active to passive or passive to active in reverse. Pronouns are also changed. ये भी आपके लिए काफी necessary. So as usually you are writing all the things from board. This also you have to write down in your notebook, but in good handwriting. And so students, that's all for today. I hope you understood it. Thank you.